From the Perfected Praise Worship Center in Garland, Texas, welcome to We Are the Next Chapter with Bishop Charles Franklin, sharing the Word of God to everyone. Join us now with Bishop Charles Franklin. We are the next chapter.
In the Lord. Hallelujah. So we dedicate this service to Shekinah Glory Church in Houston, Texas. Hallelujah. Open your Bibles, please. Draw your weapons. Let's go to war. Let's go fight. Let's go give the devil a black eye. Oh, glory be to God. Let's go to Luke, St. Luke, Dr. Luke. Let's find that 11th chapter. Glory. I feel good down in my sanctified soul. Sister Giddens, how you feeling this morning? Amen. Amen. You look good. Glory. You see, when you look good, you ought to feel as good as you look. Amen. I told Barbie, whoops, I'm sorry. I told Deaconess Tubbs this morning just to look up on her face. Hallelujah. Gave me joy. Hallelujah. Lady Pettis, how you feeling this morning? Yeah, you are. Yeah, you are. Glory. I'm going to be reading from the Amplified, the Gospel according to St. Luke, the 11th chapter. I'm going to read verses 1 through 4. Reads like this: Then he was praying in a certain place, and when he had stopped, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples. Verse number 2, and he said to them, when you pray, say, Our Father, who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. Hail holy and revered on earth as it is in heaven. Verse number 3. Give us daily our bread, food for the morrow. And verse 4, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves also forgive everyone who is indebted to us, who has offended us or done us wrong, and bring us not into temptation, but rescue us from evil. You may be seated in the presence of the living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to talk about when you pray, say. When you pray, say. In this season of Lent, PPWC is on a 40-day prayer, fast, and we're being attacked. We are being attacked. But you see, if we weren't doing anything, he wouldn't want to buffet us. And so what we have to do, we have to keep on praying. We got to keep on pushing. You got to keep on loving. You got to keep on giving. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can't stop now. Hello. I'm saying something. And so yesterday on my way back from Navasota, Texas, oh, Pastor Eveline eulogized his wife, that just touched my heart. I can't say that I understand because I'm not where he is. But I can say he loved his wife. Now there I can stand in his shoes because I love my wife. Do not find it strange that because you're being obedient unto leadership, that in this season of Lent leading up to Easter, you're being attacked. Amen. As a matter of fact, count it all joy. Hallelujah. Now, if you're not going through anything, you're the one that's not praying. Hallelujah. You're the one that's not fasting. You're the one that's not doing the reading plan. Glory. Yeah, I just wanted to let you know that you ain't going through nothing, you ain't doing nothing. Amen. So God told me, coming from Navasota, I want you to do a series, one or two Sundays, when you pray, say. And the Lord's Prayer, as we call it, God said, I want them to understand it. The Lord's Prayer, Sister Giddings, has become just a prayer of repetition. But we don't really understand, Elise, what we're praying. The confusion in the title is beautifully illustrated by a conversation between two men who were boasting of their respective knowledge of the Bible. So the first man commented to his friend, why, you don't even know the Lord's Prayer. His friend stated that he certainly did, and at least he began to pray. Now listen. He said, now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. When he had concluded, his friend said, well, you sure fooled me. I didn't think you knew the Lord's Prayer. For the want of accurate information, much of the same confusion surrounds our use of the title, the Lord's Prayer. Technically speaking, since that wasn't funny to y'all, technically speaking, the Lord's Prayer is really found in John 17. That's the Lord's Prayer. He could never have prayed the prayer recorded in Matthew 6 and Luke 11 to us, that to us has always been known as what? The Lord's Prayer. For instance, he could not have used the first word, our. I want you to follow me now. Have you taken note of the fact that his relationship to God is different from that which we hold? Amen. So he couldn't have said our. Amen. We call him Father because of regeneration. He called him Father because of his place in the Godhead. He was always careful to use the terms my Father and your Father, never our Father. Luke, I use Luke, most preachers preach from Matthew. And if you go look at the Lord's Prayer in Matthew 6, there is a doxology on it. But here in Luke 11, there is not. So a lot of times we have even missed the differentiation of the two gospels. They speak the same up until we say, and do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Amen. Glory. I didn't see nobody reach and run over there and run over to Luke 6 and see if what I'm talking about is right. But those of you that's watching me, you take a moment to run over there to Matthew 6 and see and make sure that I know what I'm talking about. Just because I'm up here does not mean that I'm necessarily an authority on the word. Amen. 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 So Luke records, forgive us our sins in the fourth verse of this 11th chapter. The Lord Jesus has no sins to confess. Amen. Amen. As far as we know, he never took an offering into the temple for himself. He was the sinless one. He said, which of you convicts me of sin? John 8 and 46. Amen. So let us consider the mechanics of the prayer. I just showed you beyond a shadow of a doubt that this is not the Lord's prayer, but we'll continue to say it. I just want you to understand that when you go to pray this prayer was for you. Hallelujah. And it is a perfect prayer. It is a short prayer. See, God believes in brevity because Jesus told them that when you go into the temple in Matthew, don't pray like the Pharisees pray, long prayers wanting to be seen by men. When you pray, say, hallelujah, hallelujah. Was given as a model to the disciples in response to their request for Jesus to teach them how to pray. Listen, it says in chapter 11 of Luke, it says, then he was praying. Jesus was already praying. Amen? Uh-huh. In a certain place. They didn't intend for us to know where. It just said a certain place. Jesus was praying, and then one of his disciples said to him while he was praying, Lord, teach us. Is that not what you read? Teach us to pray. So a lot of us are like the two men who knew nothing about the Lord's Prayer. That was my illustration. When you can't even pray a prayer at night, you got to say, now, Lord, as you lay me down to sleep. That's a nursery rhyme. That's what we gave to our kids. But here is a grown man. Hallelujah. Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. Well, that's a good prayer. That is a prayer to end the day. And if you don't wake up, you pray that you go to heaven. But we ought to, when we pray, say, our Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Which art in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Ah, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. When you pray, say, give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. When you pray, say, and do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. How many of you remember that when Ananias of Damascus was sent over to see Saul of Tarsus, he was told, you will know him, for behold, he is praying. Amen. Acts 9, verse number 11. That's what it says. Amen. There are two characteristics that stand out in the Lord's Prayer. I hope that you'll allow me to mention them because they're important. First, there is the simplicity of it. Amen. It's a simple prayer. And then there is brevity. It's brief. Amen. Simplicity and brevity ought always to characterize genuine prayer. See, a lot of us feel that because we're on this prayer fast that We got to pray in our prayer closet a long time. God doesn't want to have to sit there and listen to you praying to him for hours on time. He has others to listen to also. I know you're saying, but God knows everything. He's everywhere and he can hear everybody at the same time. But don't you know that when everybody else has been brief and you're still going on, you're in his ear. God saying, make your prayer. When Jesus told him, this is how you should pray. When you pray, begin your prayer with our Father. Right. You can even say my Father. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who sits in heaven? You're recognizing where he is. The Father that you're talking to. Oh, glory be to God. When you bow down at night and you say, now I lay me down to sleep, I pray to the Lord. Who you talking to? Who you talking to? Those two men had no idea what real prayer really is, and we as a body of Christ don't know what real prayer really is. So God said that in the midst of Lent, in the midst of you being on a praying fast, in this midst, why don't you teach them that when they pray, say, my heavenly Father, who sits in heaven. Let the devil know who you're praying to. Let the devil know that as you're praying, you're going to get your prayer through, because it says, be anxious for nothing, but in all things by prayer and supplication, make your requests known unto the Lord. How do I do that? You bow down on bended knees. You look up to heaven and you say, our Father who sits in heaven, how holy is your name. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Thank you, Lord. It's simple. It's brief. So looking more closely into its structure, I found that there are also two major divisions, my dear wife, in this prayer. There is that part of it which deals with the glory of God. I just believe that before we ever pray a prayer, we ought to deal with the glory of God. We ought to let God know that we understand who he is. We ought to let God know that we're grateful for him redeeming us. We ought to let God know that we're grateful for him taking our sin and putting it in remission. Hallelujah. 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 The glory of God. He said, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And then there's that other division which deals with the wants of us. Amen. Give us this day our daily bread. So as we look closer at these petitions, hallelujah, let although it was given by our Lord as a model prayer, this prayer is never repeated. Watch this. Never repeated in the book of Acts. As far as we know, the apostolic church never, somebody say never, used the Lord's Prayer. As a matter of rich spiritual exercise, you will find it profitable to compare this prayer to Paul's prayers in the epistle to the Ephesians. I think you will find that Paul moved to a higher spiritual realm in his praying. When we stand in the revealing light of the Sermon on the Mount, you ought to go over there and read that in Matthew 5, Sermon on the Mount. Sermon on the Mount is really the Lord's Prayer. Ooh. You'll see a correlation there. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. As a matter of fact, I just want to run there for just a minute. Matthew 5. Because, see, it's going to be some other parts to this, so I don't have to rush. Amen. See, in Matthew 5, oh, glory be to God, looking at verse number 3, it said, blessed. In other words, happy to be envied and spiritually prosperous with life, joy, and satisfaction in God's favor and salvation, regardless of their outward condition, are the poor in spirit, the humble, who rate themselves insignificant, second, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. What is it? Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. In other words, God was saying, it's not about your condition. When you are born again, it's not that you might live on Skid Row. It's not that you might live in Beverly Hills. I see all of you as the same, regardless of your situation, regardless of where you live, regardless of what you drive. That's what the scripture is saying. And so the writer here said, blessed, happy to be envied, to spiritually prosper with life, joy, and satisfaction in God's favor. I'm reading from the Amplified. And salvation, regardless of my outward condition, are the poor in spirit, the humble, who rate themselves insignificant. Oh God. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. God said, my kingdom is for all people. Hallelujah. This prayer is for all people. Then he said, blessed and enviable, happy in the fourth verse, with the happiness produced by the experience of God's favor, and especially conditioned by the revelation of his matchless grace, are those who mourn. Wow. Wow, is it not a time that we find ourselves in the midst of mourning, that we need the power of God, that we need his grace and his mercies? I watched Pastor Eveline on yesterday stand before a standing room only, hallelujah crowd, talking about how God has blessed him with a wonderful wife, call her sweetie, and said, Lord, I told her, and I'm going to be honest with you, my bed is a river. I don't understand how I'm gonna get through this. He said, but I know that if I put my trust in you, somebody say, when you pray, say, our Father. Eveline had to acknowledge that God's got him. God called her, so God's got him. God called her, so God's got something for him. Yes, we're gonna cry. Yes, we're going to mourn. But the writer said here, his matchless grace are for those that mourn. They shall be comforted. Hallelujah. I'm gonna stop there. I'm not gonna go anymore. But I want you to go over there and this week, while you're doing your prayers, go over in Matthew 5 to the Beatitudes and come back over here to Luke 11 and see if you can't tie them in together. Oh, you're going to find out. You see, when you really learn what this prayer is all about, it'll change your spiritual life. It'll change your prayer life. Hallelujah. Sometimes you don't really know what to pray. Well, you can pray, our Father. Hallelujah, which art in heaven. Glory, glory. You never need not be without a prayer. Jesus gave his disciples a prayer. The disciples gave it to the body of Christ. Hello. And it's still beneficial for today. Glory. Hallelujah. He says, there is no mention of salvation. Amen. I'm talking about in the Sermon on the Mount. It's not a cover for sin. It condemns us. Oh, did I just say something? I'm going to back up. When we stand, listen to me, in the revealing light of Sermon on the Mount, how great is the need to reverence it. It is not a cover for sin. It condemns us. It's not a savior, for there is no mention of salvation, faith, or grace. But the Beatitudes is a judge that looks at us as sinners and causes us to flee to the Savior for refuge. Law is justice, not mercy. When in sorrow, I consider where I stand under the justice of that law. I can turn with rejoicing to the mercy of his grace. Wow. For it is not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us. Titus 3:5. Oh, gosh, somebody, I think somebody just got what I'm talking about. I tell you what, let us look at the gem. I got 36 minutes. Let us look at the gem nestled in the very heart of this great Sermon on the Mount. Seen in its proper perspective, the Lord's Prayer will have a new meaning for you. Amen. If you see it in its proper perspective, it's a guide to prayer. It's a guide to prayer that we should reverence it. And we ought to stand in awe and wonder before it. We dare not repeat it carelessly in church service. For the time may appear when praying of it will become the cry of our hearts. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed are the poor in what? Hallelujah. Think about that. Think about being poor in the spirit. God made a way. Amen. Amen. Our question is the Lord's Prayer for today? I think the key to the answer is in the Gospel of Luke. There he writes that the disciples went to the Lord Jesus and said, "Teach us to pray." So he gave them this model prayer. Then he gave them a parable that in my judgment, now this is me, holds the placement of the Lord's Prayer for us in this day. Listen, the parable is about a man who, having unexpected guests, you got your Bibles open right there, you should have, and if you, where Jesus concluded the prayer, now it goes into a parable. Yeah, this is not a shouting sermon. That's the thing about being, you know, live on live stream or whatever. A lot of pastors want to make all of their messages for all people. This is for all people because a lot of you out there can't pray, don't know how to pray. Amen. We can't come every Sunday and make you shout. We can't come every Sunday, hallelujah, wanting to give you Kool-Aid when you ought to be drinking hot tea. Amen. Woman of God, there is something on your heart, and I want you to get it off. I want you to let it go, and I want you to let God have it, because you see, the enemy wants to sift you as wheat. Glory. You're having spiritual problems now that you never had before. I said spiritual problems. And that's because you made up in your mind that it's time for me to give God my service. Dancing is all right, but I got more to give. So let go. You're going to find here at this house that God speaks. See, a lot of preachers, when they speak, they're so into the sermon, they forget about the people. But when I preach, I'm looking at all of you. Because I want to see where you are. I'm glad the mask deal is down, only for the sake of in here, we don't have to wear them. And I can see your face. Amen. But when we go out, you use your good sense. You put your mask on. Amen. You wear your mask. Hallelujah. Glory. But Corona can't abide in here. This is a house of health. I pray above all things that you be in good health and prosper as your soul prospers. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Ain't no sickness in God's house. Thank you, Lord. Only reason them other people caught the coronavirus in them churches when it first when we were first quarantined is because they were disobedient. Oh. Yes, disobedience will bring about sickness. I thought you knew. Remember that, baby? I still use that today. Hallelujah. Rites of passage. Yeah, the wife went through a rites of passage. She had to make a speech. And she was trying to introduce me and tell everybody. Glory. She put my name out there and looked out at everybody and said, "I thought you knew who my pastor was." Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm serious. I want you to let it go. Let it go. So listen, the parable says, it was about a man who, having unexpected guests arrive during the night, he knocked on the door of his neighbor, and he asked that he loan him a loaf of bread. I preached a sermon on that called A Knock at Midnight. Hallelujah. Because it was at midnight. Most of us are asleep at midnight. So the man had to just keep knocking. The man and his house was asleep. Amen. Yeah. It's right there in your Bible. Glory, hallelujah. He asked him to loan him a loaf of bread to feed his guests. See, he had some guests come late, and he didn't have nothing to give them, so he goes next door to disturb a man that is already sleeping to take care of your guests. Oh, y'all, okay, all right. I figured you already knew the story. The neighbor replied that the family was asleep and he did not wish to have the household disturbed, so the man would have to wait until the morning. But the man continued to knock. Amen. Yeah, he continued to knock until his neighbor did what? He got up out of bed. And he let him have the bread, not because of feelings of friendship, but because of the persistent knocking. Hello? Somebody got that. Somebody got that. But that's why he got up. It wasn't because he was his friend, but it was because of the person's persistent knocking. Amen. In taking this parable as the key, we have to remember that Luke gives us parables by contrast. The point simply stated is this: do you think God slumbers? He does not. Behold, he keeps Israel, shall neither slumber nor sleep. Psalms 121 and 4. Do you feel that you must bang on the door to get God to hear you? No, he's ready to hear and answer the prayers of those who come to him. But he also says, like this man, you are to go persistently and knock at the door. Oh, glory be to God. Keep on reading, and it says, ask and it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door will be open. When you pray, say, Our Father. The Father that never sleeps. The Father that never slumbers. The Father that's there when you knock on his door. The Father that is there when you ask. The Father that is there while you're looking. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I say to you, ask and it'll be given. I say to you, seek and you shall find. Knock. And it will be open. If you pray the Lord's Prayer as that man standing at the door of his neighbor at midnight, knocking to gain something in the time of emergency, then I say to you, use the Lord's Prayer. When you pray, say, Our Father. Hallelujah. Knocking to gain something in your time of emergency. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It was given to avoid vain repetitions. When it becomes the cry of the human heart, then we can say, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Knowing that God does not slumber. Knowing that God does not sleep. Knowing that God wants to hear and answer your prayer. Have you prayed like that to God recently? Have you gone to him persistently, knocking at midnight? Oh, glory, hallelujah. Some of us need to get up. Some of us love sleep too much. When your heart is burdened, you ought to just get on up. If it's midnight, go ahead and knock on the door of God and let God know, I got an emergency. So when you pray, say, Our Father. I am of the thinking that there are three petitions relating to God and identified by the little pronoun your. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. And then there are four petitions relating to man and marked out by the words our and us. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts. Do not lead us into temptation and deliver us from the evil one. Although the above breaking down of the Lord's Prayer is essential to our understanding, we will turn from it and concern ourselves for the present. Oh, glory, hallelujah, with the introduction or invocation of the prayer. Three striking statements lie here in the introduction. Three striking statements lie in the introduction. Deaconess, it says, our Father in heaven, and holy be your name. Hallelujah. 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 The next time you go to pray and words won't come out, when you pray, just begin to say, our Father, hallelujah, in heaven, holy be your name. God, I got an emergency. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. The parable said the man had to knock and he had to keep on knocking because it was midnight. He didn't want to be inconvenienced. He didn't want to be bothered. You were disturbing his family, so he didn't want to get up, but the man kept on knocking at midnight. That's the best time to pray. No television. No rhetoric. No dialogue going on. Oh, glory be to God. It's still. It's quiet. Hallelujah. And when I got an emergency, it always brings about chaos. But that's what I love about my Heavenly Father, is that when I'm in the midst of chaos, I need to steal away in the midnight hour, bow down on my knees and look up to heaven and say, my Heavenly Father who sits in heaven, how holy is your name. You've given me a dwelling place, a secret place of the Most High God. I dial 911. I don't have to knock, because when I call, he answers, because he doesn't sleep nor does he slumber. So when you pray, say, our Father. Well, let's look at our Father. Let's look at it. Glory. Often we find ourselves turning to that great field of music, you know, the spiritual, for the gospel in homespun. You know, I got up this morning and I put on Sister Carr and her new album. I got to hear it. I got to hear Jehovah. I got to hear change. I got to hear that I'm in a place that I've never been before. Oh, hallelujah. And don't know how I got here. Isn't it amazing how the feel of music, the spiritual, the gospel, we sang I Need Thee Every Hour, which is a gospel. We need that, because we as people of color, music has a way of soothing our soul. Amen. Somebody ought to say amen. Ah, glory. It's everybody talking about heaven and ain't nobody going there. Not everyone becomes a son of God today. Just because we are members of the human family does not grant us the position whereby we can say our Father. Don't miss it. I just told you some of us don't qualify. Hallelujah. See, often we find ourselves turning to that to that feel of music, but it doesn't necessarily mean that it can soothe your soul and make sure that you're qualified. Amen. Watch this. Listen to me. Listen to me good. We're living in a day of beauty parlor religion. Amen. We settle for bubble bath salvation instead of being plunge beneath the crimson flow that washes us white as snow. We have mouthwash conversations instead of becoming new creations in Christ Jesus. We wear toothpaste smiles on our faces instead of the joy of the Lord in our hearts. We talk more about Halo shampoo than about the fullness of the Holy Spirit. We give talcum powder testimonies rather than those saturated with the fragrance of Christ. We live rose water lives than lives manifested in the light of the rose of Sharon. There is lipstick redemption instead of the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Synthetic jewelry is being worn instead of adorning the gospel of grace. And the glamour of Hollywood is being substituted for the glory of the holiness of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're living in a day of beauty parlor religion. Oh, glory. We got to rise above the sham and come to an understanding of the fact that everyone is not a son of God. We can become his son in only one way. But as many of us receive him, to them he gave the right, or even better, the authority, for that is the meaning of the word, to become children of God. To those who believe in his name, John 1 and 2. My brothers and sisters, this is the first statement. Our Father, your precious possession for use in prayer. Your precious possession for use in prayer. Hallelujah. Can you rightfully use it before the throne? Is he your Father through faith in Jesus Christ? Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Shame is coming upon some folk. Oh, hallelujah. We run around here. See, I don't like everybody using my name. Glory. We got more Pettises in the church than we do Franklins. But the Pettises ain't gonna loan their name to everybody. Glory. Hallelujah. Married, divorced, yeah, I can't hide that. It's public record. One of them women wore my name until they got married a year ago. I said, glory. Because, see, I've changed. But some people got your name and they don't change. Are y'all getting what I'm saying? You can't holler Jehovah Jireh, my provider, and you don't have a relationship with him. Good God Almighty, when you pray, say, you better know that you got a relationship with him. Hallelujah. I heard the testimonies on Thursday night on the prayer line. And I'm listening to all of those testimonies and how God has blessed in such a tremendous way. And as I was listening, sometimes it's good to be late. That was a good day to be late because I got to do an assessment of the ones that were giving the testimony. And God took me back to Sunday and how all of those that gave a testimony were the ones that he had touched with his grace and his mercy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I heard the power of God in one. And this morning, I heard the love of God. In other words, what God did last Sunday was he restored us to our salvation. Restored us to the love of the Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. Ah, they say the proof is in the pudding. Oh, we got to get rid of beauty parlor religion. We got to stop settling for bubble bath salvation. Hallelujah. 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 Make sure that you're qualified. Amen. Glory be to God. It also points out to us that our faith, our humility, our love of God and man with which we are to approach. I said our love with man. That's why Jesus said this is the excellent and perfect prayer, because it says our. You include somebody. You're not selfish. It's not all about you. our Father. In other words, evangelist, he belongs to you as well as me. Prophet, he belongs to you as well as me. Minister, he belongs to you as well as me. Elder, he belongs to you as well as me. So when you pray, say, our Father. God is somebody else that's in the same predicament that I'm in. I might not know their name, but I'm gonna tell you, I can say, our Father. I'll include them, whoever they are, in my prayer. Our Father who sits in heaven, how holy is your name. Oh, glory be to God. And because you're holy, because you're right, you're perfect in my sight. Oh, glory, hallelujah. I can call on you in the midnight hour and you go answer. I can call on you in the noon hour and I know you'll answer. I can call on you early in the morning and I know you go answer. So when I pray, I say, our Father. Hey, no more synthetic jewelry. Oh, glory be to God. No more glamour of Hollywood. Oh, glory be to God. But only God's holiness. Only God's adorning the gospel of grace. Oh, glory be to God. No more mouthwash conversations. We're new creatures in Christ Jesus. Somebody say, yeah. Yeah. Oh, glory. I don't know where that came from, but I feel all right. Oh, glory be to God. You see, I learned a long time ago how to become a prayer warrior. God showed me the Lord's Prayer. Stood in a conference in the AME church, and I talked about the Lord's Prayer. That was the day that God showed me that the prayer goes deeper than on the surface. Hallelujah. We have too many surface prayers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My clock has stopped, so I'm not sure how many minutes I got. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The preface, my brothers and sisters, our Father who art in heaven, it lays a general foundation for prayer. Amen. Comprising what we must first know of God before we can pray in confidence of being heard. See, that's another problem, woman of God. We don't pray with confidence. And if you don't pray with confidence, you're not praying with faith. You got to know that you know that you know he's your Father. Oh, we all got happy. Oh, glory be to God. On the last song that they danced to. Oh, glory be to God. And how can you get happy and you don't know who you're getting happy about? How can you get happy when you don't have a relationship with the one you claiming you have? Oh, y'all not hearing me? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. Our Father, who art good and you're gracious to all. Our Creator. Somebody say, our Creator. Our Preserver. Oh, hallelujah. The Father of our Lord and the Lord of us. Amen. Your children by adoption. Somebody say, I'm adopted. Adopted. Don't hate adoption. Amen. Hallelujah. You were lost. Your parents gave you up to sin. Oh, y'all not hearing me? Oh, glory be to God. And because your parents gave you up to sin, you became an orphan. Oh, glory be to God. And God came along. I heard him say, for I so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I was an orphan because I was in darkness. But God came along and he stopped by the, oh, glory be to God. house where me and several other sinners were living. Oh, glory be to God. And he said, I'm going to adopt that one. 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 I'm going to adopt this one. And glory be to God. When he adopted us, he brought us out of darkness into the marvelous light. That when we pray, we can say, our Father. Why is he your Father? Because when I was sinking deep in sin, far from a peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, never to rise no more, my Father came along and he adopted me. Oh, glory be to God. That's the only thing that saved David. David understood that in sin did my mother conceive me, but God came along and he washed me in the blood of the Lamb. He cleaned me up. He picked me up out of the muck and the mire. Oh, glory be to God. And now, somebody say now. And now, I'm saved. I'm saved from the bottom of my feet to the top of my head. I'm saved. Oh, glory be to God that I don't have a Hollywood religion. I'm saved. And now, when I pray, I can say, our Father, Father of our Lord. This phrase recognizes our allegiance to God. He is our Father. He created us. He sustained us. He gives us spiritual life. Everything that we have and everything that we are or ever hope to be, we owe it to him, the all-powerful creator who lives on the inside, who lives on the outside of time and space, in the realm we call heaven, is our Father, our God, our life, and our Savior. When we pray, we must be aware of exactly who it is to whom we are praying. Those who pray like this are members of a family, and they look to God as the head of the family, one who is bound. Somebody say bound. Bound. Bound to them by the ties of love. Oh, glory be to God. Every time I look out and I see my girls, I think about how we're tied together in love. I got a son on the way. He's not even here. Hasn't seen the day of life in his mama's womb. But I love him, and he's tied to the Franklin family by love. We're tied to the Heavenly Father by love. Somebody say, I'm tied. I'm tied to God by love. Love. Love lifted me. Love cleaned me up. Love gave me a new lease on life. Somebody shout love. Oh, glory. Woo! Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 When you pray, when you pray, when you pray, say, our Father. Oh, glory. We'll get heaven next week. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. God gave you enough. Ooh, my soul loves Jesus. Ooh, my soul loves Jesus so much. Oh, glory be to God. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the Lord on my side. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Because he loved me, he's given me a son. Because he loves me. Oh, glory be to God. Not because I've been so good, not because I've done everything right, but because he loves me. Love covers a multitude of sin. Oh, y'all not hearing me? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I gotta quit. Whoo, glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Evangelist Kylie, and then I'm finished. Going to Navasota the other night, Naomi and I, we had to take Highway 75 into 90 to go into Navasota. Oh, glory. Play some music, Deacon. And as we were going, it's a two-way road. You got those coming and those going, and I begin to explain to Naomi that if it's a solid line on your side, you can't pass. If it's no solid line, then you can pass. And then you will go up a hill, and as you're going up a hill, you can't see what's in front of you. And then all of a sudden, there's just a drop. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And as I was going, and we were talking, God showed me that's how our lives are. And as we're on this two-way road, we got to know when to pass and when not to pass. And God says, don't worry. When you get to the top of the hill, don't worry what's down below, because I got you. So I kept my speed up. Oh, glory be to God. And every time I top a hill, I drop. And I say, God is with us. Oh, glory be to God. We laid up at our hotel, got there early. Hallelujah. 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 But I began to pray. Because with 18-wheeler in front of us, cars in front of us, and didn't know that if I went up that hill and I dropped, would that car be unstalled? Would that car be unstopped? And God said, don't worry about it. I got you. If the line is in your lane, don't you pass, son. You just keep on going. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you top that hill, don't worry about the drop. I got you. Hallelujah. That's love. See, that's what love does for you. Love protects you. Oh, glory be to God. Love wraps its arms around you. Glory be to God. Love will give you a kiss. Oh, hallelujah. Love will pick you up when you're down. Love will clothe you when you're naked. Love will put a roof over your head when you need shelter. I'm talking about love. Love kept us. Love brought us back. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Glory. So, brothers, sisters, those of you out there watching us, glory. We are at 220 West Kingsley Road, Suite 456, Garland, Texas. That zip code is 75041. I think I've been given three, but it's 41. Amen. Our website is ppmc24.org. Our phone number is 214-501-4774. Give us a call. We'll get back to you. You can email us at ppwcgarland@gmail. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.com. We also have a TV broadcast. We're on Gospel America Network. That's Sundays at 4 p.m. Monday through Saturday, we're on demand. To God be the glory. May God keep you. May God bless you. May God make his face to shine upon you. And I pray that this week will be a week of peace. God bless you. God keep you until we meet again.